Welcome to this Getting Started tutorial on how to connect and submit analytics processes to the RapidMiner server. The server allows you process execution, queuing, and scheduling in your secured enterprise environment. It also includes, besides other features, user and group access management, connection setting, and other security and integration features, such as single sign-on and LDAP. Nevertheless, let's start this tutorial in RapidMiner Studio, which is your design environment to create, test, and optimize processes before putting them into production on the more powerful and scalable server platform. The first order of business is to establish a connection to your server by adding a server repository. The starting point for that, as for a usual local repository, is the repository panel. So we'll click on the plus sign and select New RapidMiner Server Repository. In the next step, we're asked to provide some general information like a repository name, the server URL, and the credentials. The alias can be freely chosen to be descriptive for your personal needs. The URL must be the domain name of the server or the IP with the port added. The standard port is 8080. To ensure that everything is set up correctly, we'll test the connection. Once the dialog shows success, we can finalize this initial setup with Finish. If you look at the repository panel again, you'll see the new repository has been established. As we expand the repository, we can see it is already populated with some folders which exist on the server. In your server repository, you can add and change folders and folder names, given you have the proper permissions, much like we show in the importing data video, so we'll skip this topic here. We will reuse the process 05 cross-validation from the validating a model video, but this time we want to run it from the server instead of locally. When we open and inspect the process, we can see that it is retrieving a data file called customer data from our local repository. Again, this is shown in the data loading via a process tutorial, in case you want to recreate what we're doing here. Now, if we would run this process as is on the server, it would fail because the data currently resides on our local machine and is hence not available on the server. To solve this problem, we'll simply copy the data to the server. We prepared a data folder under the admin home for this. This will make the data always available to the server. In a real-world scenario, this data would of course be retrieved from a database or a web service to which the server's connected. The next step is now to also move the process to the server. Again, we simply copy and paste, or since we already have it open, we'll just save it under a server folder. We'll call it 05 cross-validation on server. Finally, we have to go into the parameter settings of the retrieve operator and point it to the customer data, which we previously moved to the server. Make sure to keep the link relative, as this will avoid issues in case your home gets moved. Voila! We are now done with our deployment. So now we'll test everything is working fine by clicking the Run Process button. The process runs, and we're still getting the confusion matrix displayed in our results view. Everything seems to be fine, but we really have just tested it locally now. To run it on the server, we'll need to go to the drop-down menu next to the Run button and select Run Process on Server. Now, to show you the difference, we'll make the process last a bit longer so we can monitor the server console and show you what's going on. So let's go back to the design view and let's have 1,000 iterations for the cross-validation. I'm now showing the console next to Studio. As we hit the simple Run Process button in Studio, you see nothing happens on the server. Now, as we select Run Process on Server, we can see the process showing up. Also, you may have realized that the Results tab has not been refreshed. This is because the connection to our RapidMiner Studio results port is, of course, no longer available, as we've now run the process on the server. And the server is an engine with no deployment GUI. So if you want to check your confusion matrix or other output later, make sure to add store operators to your process. Since we've just been talking about working in a shared server environment and seeing the process scheduler, let's briefly touch on that topic as well. If you want to schedule a process, you simply select the option from the drop-down menu next to the Run Process button. The dialog gives you the option to run your process once. Maybe you want to have it executed during nighttime when the system is less busy. Also, you can of course run it via a cron schedule in case you need it regularly, like every second, minute, or hour, or once a week before the weekly business review. I'm setting this up for 7 a.m. each day. Here's an example, and in the main scheduling dialog, you can then see that the expression has been built accordingly. One more thing to notice is the process execution queue field. Here you can define to which queue you want to add your process. This will be discussed again in the more general server introduction tutorial, but in brief, adding your request to a certain queue might give it higher or lower priority for execution in case there's a shortage of computing capacity on your server system. This concludes the tutorial on connecting to a server and running processes remotely. Thank you very much for watching.